Everyone, glad you're here on the floor. We're in severe weather preparedness week right now, and we're on your side giving you a safety check on what you need to have packed and ready to go just in case you have to get to a safe place fast.
So Jonathan Hardison and First Alert meteorologist Tania Michelle are joining us now live with those answers. What do we need to do to prepare?
First of all, Tania, thanks for having me in as your guest in the Weather Center quickly.
Absolutely.
For this on your side safety check, where it is on parents' mind as we're starting to figure out, okay, February is not really severe weather season so much, but it is getting close to that in the spring. So how do we prepare? What do we want to put in those kits for to be ready to take with us when severe weather does hit?
Absolutely, Jonathan. So I made this list. This is not the most important things that you need, but these are some of the items that I call additional.
Okay.
We'll get to the best for last, or what's most important last, all right? So number one, a whistle. Do you know why you might need that?
In case you're trapped and need to get rescuers to you.
There you go. Okay. And if your phone doesn't work, a whistle's a great tool to have. Dust mask, in case there's debris, that keeps you from being contaminated from anything that's in the air. An infant, your infant formula, bottles, that's important to make sure that your infants are well fed. Blankets and pillows are also additional items that I still think are very important. But some of the main things that people need, water, staying hydrated, food, that NOAA weather radio. We always say have multiple ways to receive weather information. That's one of the next things, and also a flashlight. Why might you need a flashlight?
Well, in case all the power goes out, right? Which is not an infrequent occurrence with all the trees we got around here. One thing I didn't see, but I know that's important for parents as well, helmets. Do you recommend having a helmet just for the safety kit, or just take one when you're in these situations, make sure, hey, we grab it on the way to the basement?
Yeah, I say grab one. That way you protect your head from anything that may be collapsing from your home. So that's really important. Protecting your head is one of the main things you want to do, but you can also use your blankets and pillows for that as well. And a lot of people nowadays might not have access to a helmet. But if you do, it's a great tool to have.
Just to bring it full circle, you can't blow a whistle if you're knocked out, right? So you gotta protect your head to be able to use all the things in this kit once it does strike.
Absolutely. You also want to have that first aid kit. Band-aids, Neosporin, things in case you get a cut, that way you can fix it earlier than later, right?
Yeah.
Medicine, especially if you have prescribed medication, bring that with you as well, because you never know how long you're going to be in that safe place. You also want to make sure you have a charged mobile device and identification, your ID, your driver's license. Maybe you are knocked out unconscious. If you have your wallet there, someone at least can be able to identify who you are.
So what I see here is a lot of different items. A couple of these, like your ID and your mobile device, you can really only grab when you're in the moment. But so much of the rest of this stuff, if you have it prepared, it's so much faster because time is of the essence in some of these storms.
Absolutely. You want to make sure you have this stored away so that you can easily go grab it in the time of a need. And then make sure that you educate your kids as well so that they know, in case they're by themselves and their parents aren't with them, what to bring with them to their safe place too.
I've always found with kids, the more prepared you are, the less scared they are, right?
Absolutely. Right, prepared and not scared.
She's got us all prepared over here, ladies. Back to you.